teeth ain't hurting that bad now. Had a minor toothache, man. Some real shit. About to go up in this G League game. Show these babies how they play on a high level. The crazy, you know, it was crazy, man. I'm always stressing, like, the interaction with your team, man. Like, even with these babies, man, you gotta make sure y'all tight as a team, man. Everybody on one accord, learning. Like me and Ken, hey, we was just talking about that shit, Ken. You should never be scared to learn new shit, or never too smart. You think you're too smart, you ain't learning, you dead.
All right, fellas, come on, let's go.
Studio today, E.
Man, we doing a mixing session, a track out session, I should say. We got Shad from Connect Studios, man. Good brother, great engineer. Of the project, the creative communicator. This called the Messiah, you know what I'm saying? It's the first joint. And, you know, also shot by Cam. You know what I mean? We got another producer here as well. Trying to get this greatness out, this balance out, basically, you feel me?
But I wonder why they
the Messiah is gonna be on a creative communicator. Like with this track, you know what I'm saying? I was in a mind frame, and I also wanted to iterate how important it is to believe in something that's bigger than you, that's higher than you. You know what I'm saying? Through some of the lyrics you might hear, a little bit of the, you know, street shit with the, you know, guns and things like that. You got to look past that. You know what I'm saying? It's meant for you to look past the bullshit, the meaning of the whole joint. It's just the Messiah. You know what I'm saying? What some people call Jesus, God, Allah, whatever you call him, whatever you call it. Believe in something higher than you. That purpose in life, it makes you a better person. It makes you a better brother. It makes you a better father, son, neighbor. Just knowing that it's a bigger purpose, and you just not the only entity, I should say. When some people want to iterate their God, they're saying they're image of God because they understand the higher power. You know what I'm saying? Knowing that, it puts you in a space and at a balance where you hold yourself accountable for your actions. When you don't have that type of structure, when you don't have that higher power, that knowledge of that, you think you can do whatever you want. It's a free fall. You don't get held accountable for your actions. You know what I'm saying? So this was the whole purpose of this track. You know what I'm saying? Just to get people to understand that it's a higher power. Think higher. Think higher than yourself. It gotta be something higher than this shit. This shit right here just can't be it. And if it is, fuck it. But just that purpose and that knowledge to carry you through freedom. Like, that's your freedom. Like, a lot of people that know these up here And right here, that's how you get your freedom, by understanding that, because then you hold yourself accountable. So that's basically what the Messiah was about when I was writing it in the space I was in. You know what I'm saying? I got boys, so I got to raise them to be men. You know what I'm saying? And I was a boy myself, and I'm still learning to this day. But what keeps me going and what keeps me positive, even through negativity, because we need both at a balance, is knowing that it's a Messiah. It's a higher power. And I'm an image of that. And I got to hold myself accountable through whatever things I do. So I just hope people get a grasp of the message I was trying to put out. You know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to preach. I'm just trying to teach and hopefully motivate. You know what I'm saying? And shit, that's the Messiah.
Big Zay!
I'm gonna tell you what you think about it. I wrote this bitch off the scratch.
Ooh.
Oh yeah, this right here, this I've been having this for some years. You see how rough it is, man.
Yeah.
It's nothing but lyrics, man.
Oh, man.
Lyrics and notes.
You
man.
Got beats?
I be trying to make beats. I be doing my little home studio type
so,
shit, you know.
And that's
to
good.
Learn.
Post-production is best.
Right. Living that's what I always hear. That's yeah. what I always hear.
So you need beats?
I need beats. Okay. Sure. I've been on YouTube.
I got you on some beats. That's you right here?
Yeah, that's me when I was in high school.
Prom. Look at him.
Right,
look at him.
One king, prom
yeah.
king.
Oh, shit. Look at
yeah,
him.
I was feeling good. That was a good night, man.
How old are you, Zay?
I'm 24. I'll be 25 tomorrow.
24. A blessing.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
My birthday tomorrow, March 1st. I'll be 25.
Your birthday tomorrow,
I'm
bro?
I'm trying to figure out what the fuck to do. I'm trying to tell you. It's like, shit is just
what you, okay,
falling.
So,
I'm like, damn, shit's falling. Like, I'm trying to...
So what you do you got a track? You got a track with a beat or whatever?
I got a couple tracks on my phone, yeah.
You got a beat?
I got some tracks on the beat, yeah.
Okay.
Some shit I mixed myself. I took the shit off the beat off Instagram, put it to, you know, on the I was working with.
Oh, but you ain't got it tracked out though, do you?
I ain't doing none of that.
But do you got a beat itself and you can record it?
Like a beat, just random beat, or what type of beat from?
Okay, what you want to do?
I'm trying
cause
to.
Cause I get you, I get you for your beat, day, bro. I get you an hour of chat to see if you got some time today, right now.
We can do whatever.
So you got something you can do?
I can, yeah, whatever you give me a beat, I'll try to write some shit down. I ain't trying. We gonna write some shit.
Yeah.
If you give me something to work on, let's work.
Do you got a beat for your own? Do you got anything for you?
I be on YouTube.
I
save that shit on YouTube. I got like 100 songs. I be on my save file on YouTube. Okay. I like them. I be on just listening
to music. You ain't got a track to. I mean, you ain't got it to the point where it's an MP3 or nothing.
No, you got it. It's all on YouTube. I can save it to my little personal file.
Okay.
I'm trying to get all that emotion.
I got some beats. I got a beat. What kind of? Okay, let's hear this and then. Yeah, then let me know what you let go through your book. Let me know your vibe right now, and then let me hear it, and then I'm gonna play a beat.
For sure.
Let me hear what you got going on.
All right, I call this 24 hours a day.
Ooh.
24 hours a day. 24 hours to decide your fate today. 24 hours a day. 24 hours to decide what you're gonna do today. In 24 hours, a man had a dream. Every 24 hours, the Messiah tell you to live today. 24 hours a day. 24 hours to decide your fate today. 24 hours a day. 24 hours to decide what you're gonna do today. If I was you, I'd pray. Because in 24 hours, somebody would die today. 24 hours a day. 24 hours, somebody would be born today. 24 hours a day. In 24 hours, somebody gonna get evicted today. 24 hours a day. 24 hours to decide your fate today. 24 hours a day. 24 hours to decide what you're gonna do today.
We're gonna put that down. We're gonna put that down, Zay.
All right, that was go through your book. It took me 40 minutes to make 30 minutes.
We're gonna put that down. Go through your book. Let me know what you want. Let me know your vibe today, and we got it.
That's the blueprint right there. The documentary, the start, the future.
Track in tomorrow.
For sure.
Yeah.
Let me know how your time looking.
I gotta look, but I don't think I got too much of nothing really going on. Yeah.
You too, Pib. You.
Oh, yeah, I'll be here tomorrow.
Let's say, okay, you'll be here too?
Plus I gotta show you some joints anyway.
Okay, cool.
Sure,
let me know
what
up.
Yeah.
You gotta
exchange.
Hey, yeah, Pib.
I'm in the studio.
I'm gonna follow you too on the room too. I'm gonna just take some joints.
Shot.
Hey, I fuck with you, dog. That shit was quick.
Yeah.
This is my first time being in an official studio.
Oh, for real?
I'm just trying to be a student.
Yeah.
You're gonna see me a lot.
For sure.
For real.
Yeah, that's good.
I'm serious.
Yeah.
You know,
What's your number?
216.
Yeah. Underdog and shit, man. That whole track is for everybody that's feeling like an underdog. For real, for real. It's a lot of people in the city, man, you know what I mean, that I talk to, that I meet, and they always like, man, I didn't talk to this rapper, I didn't talk to this rapper, all Cleveland or Ohio-based rappers or DJs or A&Rs, you know what I'm saying, all that shit, and they story all the same, you know what I'm saying, it's all like, man, they don't want to respond, or they putting other people from different states, and you know, so much talent in Cleveland and in Ohio. You know what I'm saying? I just don't understand how it ain't hella rappers or singers and more DJs and more promoters that ain't, you know what I'm saying, being emphasized in Ohio, man. We got a nice amount of stars that's on, you know what I'm saying, right now that can put a lot of other people on. But one thing that's so fucked up is that when you the underdog, they scared you're gonna take their position. And that's some shit that's within they self. And that's some corny shit, you know what I'm saying? To feel some type of way like, oh, this motherfucker gonna steal my money or take my fans or like any type of fuck ass shit like that. Like why would a man even be jealous of another man? Like he ain't me, he ain't you, why would I be jealous? It's like some retarded dumb ass shit. But that's what we're going through in Ohio, especially in Cleveland. You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing. Like, you doing dope-ass pictures, dope-ass videos. You know what I'm saying? You got a guy like Logan who don't feel no type of insecurity where he could be like, hey, man, come on. Come in. Let's do this together. See, that's what it takes. You know what I mean? And that's why I always root for the underdog, you know what I mean? No matter what situation it may be, because that's how I've been felt my whole life, like an underdog. And there's so many people just like that. So, you know what I mean? That's what this track basically about, just trying to uplift the underdog, those who feel like they ain't heard or seen, you know what I'm saying? And it's a lot of us out here. You see California, you see New York, you see Atlanta. All them motherfuckers, whether they don't like each other or not, man, they representing their city, they state. That's what they doing. That's why them states, when it comes musically and entertainment shit, them motherfuckers gonna be on forever, man. If I put you on, I'll never be broke. If I put this, and then you put another person on, we'll never be broke. And then they put another person on there, we'll never be broke. Like, niggas gotta get about their ass, man. Get about their feelings, man. You know what I'm saying? So that's basically what this track was about. We was talking about Dolph before you start recording. And you know what I'm saying? That's what Dolph was doing. It's sad that people like that don't get protected, man. That motherfucker should have been protected. Him or Nipsey. All the motherfuckers that's putting people on in their cities, man. In their states. You know what I mean? Them motherfuckers ain't get protected. How the fuck he ain't protected? He should be protected like the president in the hood. All them kings should be protected. Like presidents, but the niggas protect the fake niggas. Niggas don't wanna get at the fake niggas and the fuck niggas. The niggas who making it hard for motherfuckers to eat. That's the stupid ass mentality, man. That's that underdog mentality. And just because you're underdog, I mean you righteous. Let me rewind that. I ain't going for everybody that's an underdog, cause some of these underdogs some fuck ass motherfuckers, man. Whether you're female or dude. I'm going for the ones who want and thriving to be better. Them underdogs who going against the ones who projected to win. That's the ones I'm going against. I ain't going against the ones that's playing both sides and shit. Oh man, you can win. And then so talking to the ones who projected to win, like, hey man, that motherfucker ain't shit. No, I'm going for the ones who going against those who already projected to win, man. Cause that's what it's all about, man. The underdogs, for real, for real. Hey, big ups to those who winning though. I ain't mad, you know what I'm saying? In my eyes, I feel like I'm winning. Cause I ain't following nobody but me. But I still feel like I'm the underdog because there's so much I want to accomplish, man. I ain't content with shit. And I thank God for everything. I just ain't content. I want more. I want everybody else to have more. I can't help the world. Shit, I'm gonna help everybody I'm fucking with. I know I can do that. Whether it's through financially, spiritually, mentally, shit, I'm gonna do all I can. If I fuck with you, even if we brush shoulders for a minute, if I can tell you something positive to help you grow and others grow, shit, I'm gonna do that too. Yeah, that's the motherfucking underdog, man, in this project wrapping up. 7 tracks, man. And shit. It's gonna be a dope project, man. A dope project, man. I'm just happy and I'm thankful. I got good brothers behind me, man, like a Cam and so many other brothers, man. You can't buy this type of support, loyalty, and work ethic. You can't, man. I pray for all my brothers, man. Even you that's watching. For real. Everybody's gonna get some drink.
As I like this American spirit, so America hear it. Murder and money, that's American spirit. The whole world in America fear it. Looking at my life and what it could have been if they knocked me with them clothes at Burlington. I sold dope to my grandpa, I was younger then.